women in film. That's what it's all about. Now there are so many. What you know, our first outing, which was on the theme was women and the dynamics of representation, is that we actually need to get a mind, you know, we need to examine, we need to dialogue, we need to discuss how women are being represented in Nollywood. I watched a film recently that was rather disturbing. It was a Yoruba movie in which a young girl insists on finishing her education before getting married or before having children. And then she finishes and she gets a good job. Whilst in school, she refuses to mess around with her other colleagues who are, you know, who are, I think they call it doing the runs, you know, and have all the aristos and all that. She refuses to do that and concentrates on her work. And she says quite legitimately, you know, the argument that the other girls are making is that, look, your parents cannot really afford to keep you in school. So you need to, support their efforts. And her response was that, it is my parents' responsibility to make sure that I am, you know, that I'm well catered for in school. And she doesn't live beyond her means, and she concentrates in school, you know, at the university. Good. She comes out, good grades, and she gets a fantastic job. She gets a good job, gets a car, gets a house, you know, with the job. And then there's this thing about her getting married. And the whole argument of the entire film, it's turned on its head because they're now saying, because this girl is well educated, earns well, she cannot get a husband. And so she has got to pretend, for her to get a husband, she has got to pretend that she doesn't earn good money, that she doesn't have a car, and that she doesn't have a house. I mean, I think it is just so ludicrous. Why bother sending the child to school in the first place? You know, now those kind of things are, I find, because this is such a powerful medium that it affects the minds of people, it's just that kind of film I would study in the classroom and look at where the script went awry. You know, because it's sending a lot of negative messages, not only to our women, but also to our men. It is telling our men that they are not capable or they are not confident enough to deal with a woman who is confident in her own skin, who is confident with her own intelligence, who is confident with her achievements. And I think that's, for the 21st century, that is just a load of codswallop. So those are the kinds of things that the women in film is set up to address. And I'm not the only one who does it. I mean, Igbo actually started one a couple of months before we had our own, you know. So people are concerned.